Μετά από αυτές τις αγωγικές ομιλίες, σήμερα δίνεται ο λόγος στους ίδιους τους εκπαιδευτικούς. Καλεσμένοι ομιλητές σήμερα είναι εκπαιδευτικοί που έχουν δουλέψει στο πλαίσιο του Open Discovery Space και έχουν διακριθεί με διάφορους τρόπους, είτε συμμετέχοντας και κερδίζοντας βραβεία σε διαγωνισμούς που υλοποιήθηκαν στο πλαίσιο του Open Discovery Space. Όλοι αυτοί οι διαγωνισμοί είχαν να κάνουν με το σχεδιασμό και την εφαρμογή καινοτόμων δράσεων στα σχολεία. Αφενός λοιπόν είναι οι νικητές διαγωνισμών, αφετέρου είναι εκπαιδευτικοί που ο καθένας στο δικό του σχολικό πλαίσιο έχει διακριθεί, έχει αναπτύξει ιδιαίτερες πρωτοβουλίες, έχει αναπτύξει καινοτόμες δράσεις. Ο κάθε εκπαιδευτικός θα μας παρουσιάσει πέραν τις δράσεις την οποία σχεδίασε και εφάρμοσε, θα μας πει και στοιχεία όμως για το σχολείο του. Και αυτά είναι νομίζω που είναι ιδιαίτερα σημαντικά για να αντιληφθούμε όλοι ποια είναι η δυναμική και ποιος είναι ο αντίκτυπος της οποιασδήποτε δράσης μέσα στα δεδομένα της σχολικής πραγματικότητας, της εκάστοτε σχολικής πραγματικότητας. Έχουμε λοιπόν μια ποικιλία δράσεων που εκτείνονται σε όλες τις θεματικές περιοχές και κυρίως αυτό στο οποίο θα εστιάσουμε σήμερα είναι όχι τόσο πολύ το γνωστικό αποτέλεσμα, αλλά περισσότερο ποιο είναι το αποτέλεσμα αυτών των δράσεων στο πλαίσιο της ανάπτυξης συνολικά του σχολείου και της διάχυσης της καινοτομίας πέραν του σχολείου, αλλά και της συνεργασίας με άλλα σχολεία. Και παράλληλα, αρκετοί από τους εκπαιδευτικούς αυτούς έχουν συνεργαστεί ιδιαίτερα έντονα με το Open Discovery Space, αναλαμβάνοντας το ρόλο του πρεσβευτή του ODS, που σημαίνει ότι έχοντας οι ίδιοι διακριθεί ως καινοτόμοι εκπαιδευτικοί, ανέλαβαν στη συνέχεια το ρόλο να κινητοποιήσουν ομάδες σχολείων σε τοπικό κυρίως επίπεδο, να συντονίσουν, να υποστηρίξουν και άλλα σχολεία, ώστε σιγά σιγά να διαχέεται και να τομεί ακόμη περισσότερο σε ακόμη μεγαλύτερο αριθμό σχολείων. Να σας θυμίσω επίσης ότι αυτή τη στιγμή το Open Discovery Space, που αρχικά είχε στόχο να εμπλέξει 2.000 σχολεία, έχει ξεπεράσει τα 2.500 σχολεία σε όλη την Ευρώπη και στην Ελλάδα, με τη βοήθεια των πρεσβευτών που ενεπλάκησαν από πέρσι, έχουμε ξεπεράσει τα 350 σχολεία. Επομένως, η συνεισφορά τους είναι σημαντική στην υποστήριξη του και την ανάπτυξη του δικτύου αυτού, αν μη τι άλλο σε εθνικό επίπεδο στην Ελλάδα. Και γι' αυτό και είναι καλεσμένοι σήμερα εδώ και οι πρεσβευτές, ώστε να μας περιγράψουν ακριβώς τις δράσεις που υλοποίησαν. Θα ήθελα λοιπόν να ξεκινήσουμε με την κυρία Παναγιώτα Αργύρη, που είναι μαθηματικός στην Ευαγγελική Σχολή Νέας Σμύρνης και θα μας παρουσιάσει μία δράση που έχει να κάνει με την φυσική αλλά και με τα μαθηματικά. Motions in Physics and Mathematical Function in a Web Inquiry-Based Learning Environment.
Good morning. Thank you being here for my presentation. I would like to comment on a notice that this conference is very important for all of us because we will have many opportunities to change our experience and our ideas in innovative teaching practices in our classroom. So, I am starting my presentation with two basic questions. How can we induce students' motivation in learning physics and math? And how can we eliminate students' negative attitudes toward this? At the beginning, I will present basic characteristics and basic principles of my scenario. And in the second phase, I would like to present this online from EASY portal. Inquiry-based learning is promoted in many European countries as a highly educational objective. Inquiry-based learning include multiple activities. Students making observation, posing citing questions, examining books and sources of information to see what is already understood, planning investigation, reviewing what is already known in the light of experimental evidence, using tools to analyze and interpret data, proposing answer, explanation, and predictions. Inquiry-based learning is often likened as a cycle or a spiral involving the questioning processes of creating research, finding appropriate responses, discussion, and feedback in relation to results. The most important is that the student possesses a dominant role in the learning process, while they are using critical and logical thinking and consideration of alternative explanation by finding answers to questions. Students learn about science while they apply to those. It is assumed that interdisciplinary courses are widely commended to help students to acquire the mental agility and critical thinking skills needed for success in the real world. These courses show students how to address complex issues and promote the synthesis of knowledge and help to draw the campus community closer together. The EASY portal has developed the technical infrastructure for designing and delivering technology and change in the disciplinary lessons following by inquiry-based learning. While we are teaching mathematics and physics in classroom, we shouldn't be limited to transmission knowledge in each subject, but the most important is to make transmission in these fields of science. We have to give multiple possibilities for cultivation of critical thinking, creativity, spirit of research and exploration, and self-motivation. Educational software as GeoGebra improves interdisciplinary teaching approaches and it introduces new forms and opportunities for learning. Finally, the last principle of my scenario is the assessment of problem solving as competencies to measure the effectiveness of inquiry-based learning. After this basic characteristic, I will present this characteristic of my scenario online from EASY portal, and I will be happy if you implement this scenario to your students and comment and exchange ideas about the results. At the first phase, we have two students should understand the definition and basic characteristic of linear motion with constant speed and the definition and characteristic of linear motion with constant accelerations. There are photos and questions to explain to students the basic concept of linear motion as speed, displacement, distance, movement. We have to notice that these concepts are used in different ways in daily life, so students make misconception. There are also graphs that students make calculation and discuss the questions with their students. Also, we add notes for teachers for introduction of this activity. I am passing at the second phase. Well, students from algebra 4 passing in graph representation of motion. From the value table, students create the graph for linear motion with constant speed, and second, linear motion with constant acceleration. Also, in this phase, there are notes for teachers. We have include more exercises for experiment and discuss and with their classmate for deeper understanding. In the third phase, from graph form of motion, students pass to algebra form. In this phase, the properties of educational software GeoGebra are essential because students could move the runners and making changes to variable of motion. You can see some basic questions that we call our students investigate from graph representation. The most important in this first graph is that the constant slope of line is the speed. So, students using their knowledge from algebra create the algebra form of equation. At the same way, we are working with graph of constant acceleration. All answers are for teachers to note. At analysis, students have to explain linear motion according to Newton's laws and making exercises for deeper knowledge. We also have add two videos for motivating them to discuss moreover. And the last phase, we give many directions and notes to teacher for expansion these interdisciplinary courses in maths and physics. There are many fields that we can use in quiz-based learning and mathematical educational software as Oscillations, Newton's law, Hooke's law, and many other fields to motivate our students. Thank you very much for being here.
I would like to let you know that there will be questions at the end of all sessions. So if you'd like to take down any questions that you'd like to address the presenters, I want to let the rest of the speakers know that the time for the presentation is 20 minutes. And so if you hear me going like this, it means that you're over the time. So far we're doing great. And also, if you would like to post some questions online, you can do this via Twitter, and you can use the hashtag OCC Athens, or you can use the Eden Secretariat account to send direct messages. I'll put it on the board later on. Thank you, Panagiota. We'll have some questions for you definitely at the end. And who's now? Yanni, would you like to take the podium? Thank you. Yanni Chiotelis, he's been an ODS enthusiast and for a couple of years now. I do not remember an ODS gathering that he hasn't been presenting something, and it's always a great pleasure to have him with us.
Hello, it's also a great pleasure for me to always to be here in Hotel in Germanica and of course to collaborate with all of you. Thank you for the acceptance of our project, of our work. The title is Implementing Innovative Learning Methods, a Two-School Example. As I can see, there is a problem with the names, which actually are at the bottom of the first slide, but I must refer to two excellent headmaster and headmistress of my previous schools. Dr. Maria Argyropoulou, which was my headmistress at the junior high school, the model experimental junior high school of Patras, and of course George Birbas, my headmaster at the general high school of Pelopio in St. Olympia. I'm referring to these two head of my schools because you will realize at the next slides why the administration of a school is important for developing innovative activities in our in schools. Of course, also Maria Theodoropoulou, a core author of this work, done excellent work in many parts of the presented innovative activities that I will present you in a few minutes. The two schools example, of course, it's a comparison actually between a rural school and an urban school. A rural school was located at the ancient Olympia, while the urban school was located at Patras. For those who are not from Greece, I can tell that Pelopio is, the citizens are almost 5,000, while at Patras we have something like 20,000 citizens. Apart from the differences between the local areas where the two schools are sited, of course, the school at the urban school was also a model experimental school. Here in Greece there are almost something like 20 or 30 schools. We call them experimental. Why? Because we are trying to implement some new pedagogical techniques, such as the excellent clusters, the excellent groups, or innovative programs related to environment and so on. First of all, the difference between the two schools are referred mainly on the different aims we had set in order to apply innovative activities. At the rural school, we had a problem about abandoning school from many students. So we have to face this problem. On the other hand, at the model experimental school, we have the challenge and of excellence. Our aim was mainly to achieve as more as possible distinctions at the contests and so on. Sorry for this. At the model experimental school, students are joined our school after exams, so they are very keen to follow and attend educational programs, excellent groups, taking part at experimental workshops. Teachers also want to take part at experimental workshops. They are also taking part at exchange mobilities and other innovative projects. while on the other hand, at the rural school, it is a vision of teachers and especially administration's vision to organize students in such groups according to their interests in order to make school a more familiar place for them. At our rural school, but also at the urban school, we have organized astronomical groups, environmental groups, drama groups, and students seem to reveal their real interests about all these activities. So this was actually the same in both schools. Also, according to the according to the orders of the administration of the schools, we followed almost the same steps. First of all, we tried to improve the equipment and improve also the building infrastructure in both schools. The second step was that teachers had to be trained and trained into new pedagogical approaches, into new innovative educational projects and research methods. This was very important because after that all these gained skills had to be transferred to students. In order, our main goal was to achieve a balance between labor market and society and school, actually to prepare our students for real life. And of course, one of our major steps was evaluation, because through looping processes, we are thinking of, we are entering into a content process of improving and finding our positives and negatives. About the urban school activities. First of all, we begin with an in-service training for teachers organized by the administration in the school, and secondly, we organized after an Erasmus Plus Key Action 1 project a wide in-service training activity for teachers. We signed some very important collaboration protocols with the Eleni Koping University, with University Patras, the Technological Institute of Patras also. Furthermore, we improved and developed further the equipment of our schools. We got at the Model Experimental School two computer labs, a very fast, high-speed internet connection. All the classes got projector and computers, which actually this is not the case in the Greek public schools. Usually we have one or two class rooms with such equipment. We tried to promote what we call the 24-hour school by developing the school on cloud, an internet site where students can find the lesson taught the day before at the school if they don't attend the if they didn't attend the school. Furthermore, we paid great attention on developing educational material, especially in the direction of interdisciplinarity, because we strongly believe at these projects of interdisciplinarity. At the first year, we developed seven clusters, seven groups of excellence, with a major aim to take part at contests and scientific competitions. This is the poster from our virtual visit to CERN, which was actually supported by the Open Discovery Space project. This was held at the Model Experimental High School, Junior High School at Patras, on December the 13. This image is from our drama group. This is from our Christmas event. We also pay great attention at the Greek tradition. This is an image from a photo from the shadow Muppet called in Greece Karagiosis. This is our choir about music and an image photo from our Christmas event also. We further proceed into some innovative activities. You can see here innovative experiments. This is a cloud chamber. This was organized at the cluster of modern physics related to element particles. And of course, our robotics class, group of excellence, which was very successful. As far as concerns the rural school activities, almost we followed the same way, the same path. We paid great attention about contests because we really want to provoke curiosity of students and raise their interest. We organized a very successful astronomical event, which was followed after a couple of months with a similar environmental event. And as far as concerns the innovative approaches, we proceeded in many synchronous video conferences with scientists. We also organized a virtual visit to CERN. And of course, as far as concerns the ICT, we tried to implement digital lessons on everyday teaching practice. And also, we further proceeded into some innovative activities related to augmented reality and using the Kinect camera for producing educational material. This image is from the astronomical event held at our rural school. Actually, this was a place near our school. We had, of course, a connection and a remote control of a telescope at Israel called the Ido Baraket telescope. So we had the opportunity to see some real images from deep sky. We had some invited talks from professors from the University of Patras. Here you can see Vasilios Zafiropoulos. Also, we had some very impressive hands-on activities from the head of the Center of Natural Science Laboratories of Ilia Kalogiru, Mr. Kalogiru. And of course, at the end of this astronomical event, we had also observation of the night sky by the telescopes of the Astronomical Union of Patras Orion. The achieved goals. One of our main achieved goals was the first place at the European contest called Odysseus, where five students from our school managed to gain the first prize. Following up, we organized an ecological event and an environmental event. We have also some invited talks, speeches from professors from the University of Patras. Also, in the way of connecting our school to labor market, we have some presentations from the representatives from the labor and chamber of products, the local chamber, and also from people from volunteers organizations that encouraged students to had some activities related to the environment. Last but not least, we organized a night about chemistry where students present their own experiments related to chemistry. We continued, of course, trying to imply innovative activities. You can see some applications of augmented reality and or air presenting, as we call the use of Kinect camera. You can see a student here presenting a presentation by not touching the keyboard at all, but only using the Kinect camera, which actually detects the hands of the presenter. This is an image from a student hunting a dinosaur. This is an augmented reality application. This photo is from a virtual visit to IRC Lyon, an institute dedicated on fuel cells. A researcher called Mike Chambas organized a virtual visit, a virtual tour for us through internet. And of course, this also was a very successful activity, where 12 schools from the area of Ilia, where ancient Olympia belongs, we organized a very successful event with a duration almost 6 months, where students from 12 different schools presented their own activities related to physics and Olympic Games. What is now common for both schools? The common is that we realized that both schools had to develop a network of collaborations with several universities, organizations, institutes, and so on. What is important in these networks is that if we also add the links between all these organizations, we can develop a very thick network, which actually is a network of ideas and knowledge flow. The same also exists at the Model Experimental Junior High School of Patras. As far as consensual conclusions, it seems that changes in operation and administration concluding to wide cooperation and participation. This is our main goal, cooperation and participation as possible. We developed a culture of innovation, which influences the local society, and this acts looping, causing back some changes to our school. Of course, this works beneficially in the way of the thinking school. We also realized that an essential evaluation can only take part after a long period of implementing innovative activities. I think after 4 or 5 years. Also, it seems that it's very important the lifelong learning of and the constant education of teachers. Also, the extroversion of our schools. It's very important for both students, their families, and the local society. Extroverts, giving students the opportunity and responsibilities to organize an event, this gives really, make students to feel important in the school environment. Furthermore, collaboration promotes the diffusion of knowledge. Students can transfer knowledge to their families, families can transfer knowledge to the local society, and so on. Local society then can influence the school back. Another remarkable conclusion is the importance of educational scenarios, material, and content. This is where ODS plays the important role. In many ways, we diffused our knowledge through this very successful platform, the platforms of the ODS. But also ODS gives us the opportunity and the ideas to go on in this kind of activities, virtual visits to CERN, astronomical events, environmental events, and so on. Participation in contests. Another crucial parameter of where ODS adds and offers a very important add. This is motivation. Contests are motivation for students. Finally, also evaluation, which is also included in the ODS, is one important step for our activities, because always we can find the positives and negatives and further plan and organize our next steps, setting our new goals and bridging the gaps. thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Ioannis right on the spot. I was ready to knock my my pen. As I said, for those who just came in, there will be questions at the end, and we'll have a mic going around, and you may ask questions in both English and Greek, if you wish.
So now I would like to invite another very interesting case of an ODS ambassador in Greece. It's Mr. Nikolaos Nerantzis. He works in a quite interesting case of a school which is a vocational and special needs school in northern Greece. And he's going to talk to us about science teaching, innovative science teaching in secondary special needs education.
Sorry.
Come from here. Never mind. Hi, I'm Nikolaos Nerantzis. I'm a physicist in a public special school in secondary education. I will have a small problem with blue. Okay. We'll see. Anyway, I like to move. Thank you for the invitation. It's almost 3 years. I participate almost in every project, Go Lab, in ODS, in ESA. It's very inspiring. Someone can ask why education? Because one child, one teacher, one book, one pen can change the world. It's so simple. We need nothing else. This is my school in northern Greece, in Seres. It's a special secondary school. It's also something like junior high and also high school. We can find not only the usual ranges of age in the students, but in the junior high school we can find something like 17. We have this arbitrary, let's say, range from for the ages. In Greece, in special education, we have inclusion classes in typical schools, and we have autonomous special schools for mild difficulties and severe difficulties. This is a school about mild and one or two severe difficulties. We can work. A few things about, you can see it, learning disabilities. About the definition, it's a neurological condition that interferes with the individual's ability to store, process, and to produce information. All these three parts can be affected. And not only. We have affection in math, in reason, in attention, in memory, in a second level. But we have to exclude, can you see it? No? No. But we have to exclude for disabilities, for leg disabilities, other problems like mental retardation, autism spectrum disorder, problems in hearing and in visual impairment. But all these are in special education. The main problems I can face when I'm teaching SEND students, we can't connect scientific ideas with mathematics. It's very difficult. Yes, they can understand the concept of velocity, but if you give them the form, it's very difficult. We have difficulties in memory. store, process, and so on. And as we know from constructivism, students' ideas are universal and it's not easy to modify it. Moreover, the old ideas stays alive in specific contexts. It's very difficult to transfer knowledge. I can accept a new knowledge for physics, but not for biology, not for the linguistics. And the best, someone says, we can do is to make a peripheral conceptual change, if you are familiar with Piaget's scheme. It's very difficult. I have here an example, what is going up, what the malfunction, let's say, in the mind of a student with dyslexia. This is our brain. When we see the word tiger, three areas are activated in our brain, in the left hemisphere. In the first, in the front, are the phonemes, to, I, do, I, are. At the second one are the syllables, tie, get. At the third one is the word as a whole. It's an optical, we say, an optical dictionary in our brain. In a student with dyslexia, the two last parts are malfunctioning. So the brain activates, thank you, activates, no? Never mind, never mind.
Sorry, we have some live streaming, so it's impossible to it's impossible to do it without lighting. Sorry about this.
Okay. So it activates the red part where the images, some visual information in order to read the word tiger. That is, take more time, of course. The left hemisphere is about analytical thought, language, science, logic, mathematics, and the red are more for creative, intuition, music, art, and the holistic thought. Okay. Now, from learning these disabilities to difficulties, and about the teacher in the typical class. In a typical class, a teacher can see, let's say, a very good student not to perform well. When this distance is very big, we say, oh, there is a problem. Perhaps he must be a diagnosed or to see it from a specialist. And we are losing very much, never mind. And the teacher's judgments are very important and are very reliable. Some research show that we can help in the early valid and reliable diagnosis because if a teacher says, oh, this guy has a problem. Perhaps we have to give him help. It is 91% for sure. It's correct about learning disabilities. 100% for mental retardation and 95% correct about the group of low achievement. There are many tools that we can use as teachers to help the diagnosis in order to have a very early estimation, not a diagnosis, just an estimation. We have a problem. Please see this guy and not the other guy. We can see difficulties in learning. We can see difficulties in the school performance and the behavior. Okay. Λοιπόν. No, in my teaching, with my colleagues and my students, first we can discuss. I'm discussing about what to do. I discuss in order to understand, I collaborate, I support, and of course repeat. All this began 3 years ago in the pathway context. So I very fond of acquire basic science education. Next, I use very much international educational practices, repositories, and all the knowledge gained about brain networks in networking, in learning. I'll explain right after. For the EcoAI and based science education, I use the 7E model. I'm very fond of the extend phase. We want to give new knowledge and to have a transfer of knowledge. In this phase, we can use we have the freedom to do this. It's for deep understanding, of course, scientific ideas, for knowledge transfer, and the development of everyday life skills. It's very important for special education. Example, in a shadow ILS, in the extent phase, I can speak about shadow puppetry and shadow economy with these two posters. When I teach light, I can speak about planets, auroras, but also art. Oh, sorry. This is for the art. Here is Picasso, playing with light. And that's some examples about auroras, the Earth, Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus. From international educational practices, I'm very fond of this brochure from International Bureau of Education of UNESCO. It is very short and very to the point. With teaching spirit from all over the world. Okay, connections. ESA, ODS, and and the Twitter. All the announcements is on the Twitter. The examples. 3 years ago, there is a didactical proposal to introduce the concept of energy flow, wave, oscillation, and disturbance. It was awarded with the third prize. The scenario includes the analogies, energy chains, posters, my posters, and some experimental inquiries with pendulums and other experimental setups. And we did this as a workshop in almost 40 science teachers in the prefecture of Ceres. Next year, it's for the Go Lab, it's on DC circuits. The initial idea was to emphasize the dialogue about experiments and real life. This week is the Eratosthenics experiment. When we go out and measure, we take 5 or 10 measurements. If I ask them, which is the real one? I provoke them, which is the real one? They don't know. It's all real. Okay. They are prisoned in the models. This is awarded with the first prize in the Go Lab National Teacher Contest, so I attended the summer school. This scenario includes also a smartphone or tablet for wireless in support of the students, comics, posters. This is an idea of very deconstructed a circuit, doing points, the microphone. We set points and we construct a polygon with the volts. It's very simple to find the algebraic sum to be equal to zero. Many symbols, many letters are confusing. And the poster with the analogy of the traffic and the electrons, the battery elevates the potential, a bridge opens its switch on or off, or a traffic light, red or green. This poster worked very well with a guy with Asperger in the third class of the junior high school. This is from this year's Go Lab teacher. I gained their first prize, and it was on open inquiry on when I left two objects to fall. But we have to use also photo and video software. Let me show you this. Okay. It is okay. Can you see it? Much better. We construct a very simple apparatus. We take the video, the guy left it, and then I take some screenshot to inquire what is going on. This is, as you can see, in this trial, the lightest goes first. And so all this conversation about what is happening, why not the heavy one, as Aristotle said. It's very joyful. This is my favorite proposal. Again, the posters from the experiment. I also said something in the Green Net competition that it was highly commented. It was about to set the citizenship in the core, although with the environment. I constructed three ILSs on water set, on waste and wetlands. It's better here. There is a post, and when you click on the image, you go to the associate ILS. And the photographs downstairs of the town, it's from the extent phase. We have, for the energy, we have new ways to do things, and this is the radioactive waste. We can escape pollution. Perhaps we can escape the black hole, but we can escape pollution. We have to do something. Here it is, lasers and bubbles. It was a didactic proposal, listed top five in this year's ESA competition. I will present in short the stages. It has four phases. We remember all the experiments, the same experiment with the same students we did 2 years ago. We went to the laboratory center of science. In every prefecture there is an office about science teaching. We did some pre-activities. And then we have the main activity with lasers and some oils, cooking oil or salt solutions, in order to investigate what happens. And there is, in the same building, there was the Heraclitum, the Science Museum, with teaching apparatuses almost 100 years old. And we extend with many items from the ESA repository. And the posters again. Now, about all the knowledge gained from the brain networks in learning. I use metacognition and meta-memory in evaluation phase. Let me present. It is important to speak about the brain in our students. Why? In special education, when we explain how brain works and what is the problem, they can help to react. It's not that you are stupid, let's say. It's something we can change it. In the lasers and bubble proposal, we use the bus to go to the town, but I choose also to walk. Why? Because after 20 minutes of a walk, the brain is more active. This is very good for our students also. On metacognition, I use some questions in the evaluation phase. They can take them home and write them. What did I like? What was difficult for me? How do I work? How did I work? Am I satisfied for my performance, for my group performance? They can rethink and evaluate. And also, a very good thing is when we do hands-on activities, many times this is hands-off for the teacher, and that is cultivates metacognition also. On meta-memory, I use some questions we can find as ease of learning or judgment of learning. There are also feeling of knowing I didn't have something to do with them, just bring it for the reference, or you can find it some SL, joke, or fop. What is that? Prior a task, I ask them, what do you think about this task? Just from looking at it. They click, easy, not easy, very difficult. Okay, after the task, so that was easy, not easy, difficult. And then again, in the evaluation phase, I ask them, in the future, how difficult for you it will be to do something like that? So, we can see what we think. Or we are underestimate our capabilities, or we are overestimated. It's very good for monitoring. Okay, about the brain. There are three brain networks involving learning. There are the recognition network in the front, there are the strategic network, let's say, at the back, and the affective network all over. Λοιπόν, the recognition network receives the information, the strategic plans and coordinates, and the affective is all about emotional dimension. I have another, perhaps better. Okay. Yes, λοιπόν. At the app, it's the affective network. It's the why. Why shall I put effort for this task? Why? The first thing of a student is why. Shall I engage or not? If he decides to engage, then comes the strategic network. What shall I do in order to be successful? And then the recognition. How shall I do it? This is all from the CASNET and the UDLNet, the Universal Design for Learning. The Universal Design for Learning gives all these guidelines in order from the beginning to, from the scratch, to do our proposal, to write down our proposal. So, the educational activities presented here, without red or green or blue, involved 10 students working in teams and as researchers. The educational outcomes are, among others, knowledge on the core scientific ideas, better relationships between teachers and students, and they boost also student self-esteem. We are in special education, we are very, very, it's five slides, very, very worried about the emotional component of learning, and we're trying to integrate it very fast. The first pillar is to remove all the obstacles and offer educational activities in order to facilitate the learning, to provide them the experience for life necessary. The second pillar is that we are engaging all these networks, and let us skip. And all this is about inclusive education. And the final, my dream is at least one of my students to go to the Mars, and at least one of my students to stand for human life like this gentleman. It's Romeo Dallaire. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Nerantzis. And now from northern Greece in Cyprus, we'll travel to a remote island, which, to be honest, I had never heard of until last year when we met Stefanos Poultsakis. It's a tiny island near Ikaria. You may have heard of Ikaria. And Stefanos is going to talk to us about his experience as a teacher in that school, and also about his cooperation and the activities he designed and implemented through ODS.
This presentation will be in Greek, so if you would like to use your receivers to emphasize what Eleni has said, this is an extremely remote island with 40 inhabitants and two teachers, an extreme special case both for ODS, but for rural education, and we have been very proud in Open Discovery Space to have facilitated this kind of rural distant education. Stefanos.
Καλημέρα και από μένα. Είμαι ο Πουλτσάκης Στέφανος, απόφυτος του Παιδαγωγικού Δημοτικής Εκπαίδευσης του Αριστοτελείου Πανεπιστημίου Θεσσαλονίκης. Κατάγομαι από την Πολυκάρπια Ριδέας.
Aristoteles University of Thessaloniki. Και apart from teaching at school, I like music and football. Since 2011, I have worked in various schools in Greece, but last year I was I spent last year as a teacher in Thymaina. Thymaina has 136 inhabitants, of whom only 6 are permanent inhabitants. The school during the school season, I had 2 students. This year there will be 1 student in grade school and 1 in kindergarten. Thymaina is a very simple but beautiful island with great views. It is a very serene island, and I would say that Thymaina is an ideal destination for vacation. For a teacher, things are different, though. I can tell you, based on my experience, that coming from a larger city in Greece to Thymaina was a big challenge. You need 3.5 hours to get to Thymaina from the nearest bigger island. Even for the locals, access is difficult to medical centers or to a bank, because inhabitants have to take the morning boat at 7 o'clock to get to Ikaria, which is the closest island. It is not only the remoteness from the other islands, it is also the weather conditions in Thymaina. It is known that Thymaina has a very variable weather, so you may be blocked in the island and have no possibility to leave because of the weather conditions. When I first heard that I would be positioned in Thymaina, I had to look it up on the map and ask what it is. And my emotions were very mixed when I arrived there. On the one hand, I was happy to have a job as a teacher at that island. On the other hand, I had the words of a colleague of mine in my mind who had said that if you can make it in Thymaina, you can make it everywhere. It took me a few days to understand what life was about in that island. I first arrived in the island of Fourni, near Ikaria, and had to find out that there was no boat to take me to Thymaina on that day. So it was only on the next day that I could arrive to Thymaina. And when I set foot on Thymaina, I realized that everyone was looking at me as if I were someone famous. The good thing was that everyone was willing to get to know me because they had heard that I was coming. You understand that I didn't have many options for accommodation in Thymaina. So after finding some accommodation, I met my 2 student girls, and the head of the school. I heard, however, when I got to Thymaina, that a big percentage of the inhabitants are affected by a rare mental disorder. So that makes them blind and retarded. There is no physician in the village. Only military doctors rarely visit this island. So the inhabitants have to deal with this rare syndrome and feel very marginalized. They feel the outside world as something remote and external and distant to them. These inhabitants of Thymaina, however, are very open to embrace refugees, migrants who arrive on the island. They take them in and give them food and shelter.
in the eyes of these people, the world is a very wild thing. And when I came to Thymaina, I saw in the eyes of the people this hopefulness, but also I saw fear in their eyes, because anything unknown to them is bad. So I believe I had to prove that they could entrust their children to me. They had to find out whether I would be the link between Thymaina and civilization. I cannot find the words to describe the emotions that I had when I first came into contact with these people. For me personally, there was no other option than to try to find access to the people. During the school year, the school was engaged in a European project and three other projects, one of which was Open Discovery Space, which was a very important venture because you have the possibility to cooperate with teachers of all levels from various places. It was a difficult, hard venture, but for me, it was an important challenge. Pella Papa, from the primary school authority of Samos, supported me as well as another colleague who urged me to participate in one further European project. And I'm very thankful to them, because I think that through the participation in these projects, I became a better person. I owe a big thank you to my friend Petros Teriopoulos, who is sitting here in this room in the back, because he was always urging me and encouraging me to take a step further and become better. And this was, we spent hundreds of hours talking through Skype and Skylight. And for those who do not know Skylight, it is a platform that Petros himself has set up. You can talk to other people, see them or talk to them only through a microphone. And through this platform, I could discuss with Petros any issue that would come up. One day, Petros talked to me on Skype and explained to me the project that he was setting up to share music and to unite or link the world. Let us share the music, let us link the world. In other words, the music should become a tool, an educational tool that would make teaching and schooling more accessible and familiar to the students. We decided to link the myth of Daedalus and Icarus to this project. And at the end of the school year, we had developed a model scenario that was acknowledged in the framework of ODL. ODS. And this was for me, it gave me impetus to further work on this platform. First, I created a platform about Thymaina so as to make this tiny island better known. Secondly, I wrote the history of the primary school of Thymaina. After becoming an active member of the platform, I was invited by Petros to join communities such as Ikaria Thymaina, Let's Share Music, and others. So with Petros as my constant assistant, I created the platform Ikaria Thymaina Music. When the action would be fulfilled, one would be able to find among a variety of actions those actions that can be implemented in their classroom. And so this is a platform where you can integrate your action, and that is also what we did. We developed an ICT action in a remote island that does not have any luxuries or any possibilities similar to the ones of urban centers. However, through this community and through a subcategory of this community that is called chats or discussions, we were able to develop an action with a duration of 3 minutes. Mrs. Katerina Boulakou from Athens would support this action and would play a melody from Greece. Konstantinos Boulakos was designing the music from another place, and from Rhodos, a third lady would participate in this action by creating the final scenario. This was a venture that was linked with many problems. However, I was able to modify the curriculum of the school so as to integrate these actions as well. These are the weather conditions in Thymaina. It is characteristic that in most of my chats with Petros, we had to have a lot of patience because the signal was not good. Another big problem was that there was no bookstore at the island. So whenever we ordered a book, we had to wait at least 10 days for our order to arrive. And many times we didn't even have signal for our mobile phones for a few hours to a few days. Therefore, we decided that our action would involve only the primary school of Thymaina and the school of Pella. It was already the end of May, and time was short. So when the books finally arrived at the islands, the students created these materials. They drew Icaros, and then I allocated roles to them. One of the students had learning difficulties, so I would have to discontinue the project if I had to work only with one of my two students. Therefore, I modified the action. I first created a text about the myth of Daedalus and Icarus, and then we dramatized the myth of Daedalus and Icarus and recorded it on video. We used a candle, the flame of a candle, and finally the form that this scenario took was that every time that there was music that accompanied the happening of the myth. The scenario may sound quite simple to you, but if you consider that one of the two students had learning difficulties, it was a big challenge. So this has been one sign of what can be achieved. Therefore, when I was positioned at the school of Polycarpi, I decided to continue with this action. Again, Petros supported us through Skyline with his music, and I would like to show you a video to see the outcomes of this work.
Ένα τεχνικό πρόβλημα από ό,τι καταλαβαίνω, έτσι δεν είναι, Πέτρο? Ε, σωστά.
There seems to be a technical problem, and we'll try to solve it right away.
Στέφανε, μπορούμε να το δείξουμε και στο διάλειμμα, εάν δεν μπορεί. Εντάξει. Μπορούμε να το δείξουμε και στο διάλειμμα.
Να το προχωρήσω.
Ναι, ναι.
Time is short, so we will not have the possibility to watch the whole video. So I just need 2 minutes to conclude. Open Discovery Space as a tool, together with Skylight, has supported us and made it possible to us to create an action that links geography, arts, and many other disciplines together. And at the same time, the students can learn more about music, geography, arts through play. Petro, Stefanos, Filica, Maria, and the children of the Polycarpi teacher made it possible to implement this project. All these children may live in a remote place, but they can be empowered to to be more enthusiastic about learning. These elements are important, and we have to understand that open discovery space actually offers children simplicity in learning. Which student does not like to laugh, to play, to draw? Most students say that break time is the nicest time during the school day. But open discovery space gives us the opportunity to make teaching and schooling more playful and more pleasant. Even if few children will become more enthusiastic. And let us not forget, there's not only Athens and Thessaloniki in Greece. We have to take into consideration that children in remote places such as Thymaina are also eager to learn. So starting with open discovery space as a tool, let us try to make a step further. I would like to conclude with some words to my colleagues who are present here. I know that we could be more methodological in our approach, but what is more important is not to give up. If sometimes we were afraid that we would not make it, it was the team spirit that helped us carry on. Many challenges, many big problems made us modify our initial aims, but we carried through and we were able to achieve something that was unheard of in Thymaina before, that there would be a platform that can be used. Of course, we made mistakes, but without mistakes, you never learn what is right. We always had the words of Lao Tse in our mind. A trip of 1,000 kilometers starts with a step forward. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Stefane. Now to Georgios Katsanis. Georgios Katsanis is a physical education teacher. He was one among 20 teachers who won a scholarship to participate in one of our summer schools in ancient Olympia. He is the author of an extremely interesting educational scenario that combines science with physical education, and he's here to share his experience with us. Georgios.
Good morning. I'd like to thank the committee for giving me the chance to share an educational scenario, and I hope that you will enjoy it as much as I did with the students. The title is Teaching Physical Education Through Mathematics, Physics, Web 2 Tools in Secondary Education, The Impact and the Challenges. The main idea was to prompt students to participate actively, especially those who aren't very skillful in sport activities, and to understand the relationship of physical education to other cognitive fields. The Olympic event of shot put was chosen because it combines features from various fields, such as mathematics, physics, biology, history, and more. By understanding this relationship, the students will feel more capable, or at least they will try to participate more actively in physical education, a subject often misunderstood in the higher grades of secondary education. Of course, information and communications technology played a very important role by bridging the different cognitive fields. And the present educational scenario included collaborative activities, learning by doing, field research, simulation, 3D modeling, and Web 2 tools. our methodology. We had three phases. The first one was we presented a motivational video and discussion, and then we created a wiki so that we have to upload all the digital content to be accessed by everyone. On the second phase, which is the main phase, we had the field test, the learning by doing, and the interdisciplinary activities with the computer science, physics, and mathematics. And of course, the third phase, which is the final edit of the material, discussion and presentation to communities such as school community, the local community, and the parents association. So, the phase one, we had a specific stimulus which is used to trigger brainstorming, where the students discuss regarding the problem and suggest a list of ideas for the structure of the project. The specific stimulus was an awarded short film named 3x3, and the story involves physical education, mathematics, physics, anatomy, and it was an excellent way to intrigue the children to participate in our scenario. For saving some time, I will have to show you the video, but please excuse me. I will have to put it in a fast forward so that we will save some time, but you will get all the main idea. We have two protagonists. The children named them the hero and the bad guy. So I will use these terms to guide you through the video, which is very... Okay, this is the bad guy, this is security guard. He's playing, he's very skillful, he doesn't miss a shot. Now we have the hero. He is the janitor. The first one is very strong about his skills. He goes up to his post, and the hero continues to do his work until he goes and he finds the ball on the field. Then, as all children do, what does he do? He will try to do what? What the other guy did. But we see that he's not very skillful. Perhaps many of us who work in school, we can see our students. Someone who is very skillful, someone who is not skillful. He doesn't give up. He tries again and again. The first reaction, we usually blame God for not putting the shot. But our hero has another set of skills. He doesn't give up. So what does he do? He starts to measure. He uses science. Distance. For our bad guy, all these things are totally strange. He doesn't understand. But someone does. And this is the interesting part. That's simple. He goes out to see what happened. Our hero is more confident of himself, and when he goes back, he has a package, which is an invitation right now, because both understand the game and how to play it. Every protagonist from his own... Okay, I feel that you enjoyed the video, so we're moving on. If you liked it, try to think what happened in the classroom. So, after they saw the film, we discussed about the story and the main idea. Through questions and answers, we start to focus on the throwing technique, which is common in many sports events, such as shot put. At the end, we gave a team worksheet so that the students will gather information regarding the use of ICT regarding the throwing event of shot put. In the second activity, we went to the lab with a computer science teacher and we created a wiki in order to put all the information in a digital form. This way, all the information, worksheet, paper, relative digital content are accessed by everyone in the team. The second phase, which is the main phase, we had learning by doing, field research, interdisciplinary lessons, and with the use of Web2 tools, the main goal was to achieve, which is to examine the relationship between physical education and other cognitive fields. So we went out to the schoolyard and we tested, we tried, we practiced the shot put, and at the end, after they get familiar with the activity, we recorded three throws using tablets. It's a very nice tool if it is allowed to use the schoolyard or in the school, using recording software. And another team worksheet was given after the throws, so the kids will have to find the progression of the Olympic records from the modern Olympics and onwards. This is a picture from the test. The good thing about software and tablet is that you can have results on site. It's very important. You don't have to go back to the lab to edit. Right on site, you can find the result. We keep the two numbers, 33 degrees and 23 degrees, in mind. I will tell you why. After the measurements, we go inside using Web2 tools again. We edit the throws to keep the part that we are interested in, and we upload them to the wiki. We also can create a 3D modeling contest using another Web2 tool, and the subject was to create a model of the stadium of ancient Olympia, where in 2004 was held the Olympic event of shot put after many, many years. An interdisciplinary lesson followed with a physics teacher where a video was presented of an Olympic game shot put athlete, and then the students had to identify the forces that are present and to name the laws of physics from the start till the end. After discussion, we discussed about the ideal throwing trajectory or the angle that the shot put has to be. And we put the theory to the test using an online simulation from the University of Colorado. The three measurements are from 30 degrees, 45 degrees, and 60 degrees. As you can see, the 45 degrees is the optimal. After all this knowledge, the recent knowledge of laws of physics and the ideal trajectory, we went again outside the schoolyard and we made the measurement again. But right now the children had to try to be more close to the 45 degrees angle. Also, we gave another worksheet with the different techniques of the Olympic shot put. As you can see, both students almost reached the optimal degrees, which is 45. This is the second test after the interdisciplinary lessons. We went again in the classroom with a mathematics teacher, and we tried to imitate the hero of the story. So we took from the school textbook of high school a mathematical problem, and they tried to solve it. After they solved the problem, they discussed with the teacher, and we also used a mathematics software, GeoGebra, to try and create the same trajectories. At the end, again in the lab, we took the first try and the last try, and we tried to put them side by side to see what was the result. So we compared them and we edited them. This is the result, before and after. First girl from 23 went to 38 degrees, and a boy from 30 to 41. In the phase three, the final edit occurs. Resulting conclusions from the project are presented to the school community. So the students take all the educational material, they edit, and they update the wiki and discuss about presenting the project to the community. And of course, at the end, the students presented their project to the school community and the parents' association. In all these activities, there were some challenges. The greatest challenge in this particular project was to inspire the students to have a positive feeling towards physical education. The use of ICT and other cognitive fields towards this goal is somehow confusing because physical education is about moving, and the other cognitive fields, usually you sit on a chair and you intake all the knowledge. Also, the different nature of various fields, such as biology, anatomy, physics, make this project even more difficult. Nevertheless, when the students understand this relationship between two seemingly totally different cognitive fields, for example, physical education and physics, then both subjects have gained an enthusiast student. Also, teachers have good intentions. When they plan interdisciplinary courses, these courses frequently lack sustainability. Two problems, potpourri, too much information, or polarity, when a teacher or both teachers feel that their field of expertise is being underestimated, they try to do more. So in order to address these problems, teachers must carefully conceive the design, and they must use both field-based and interdisciplinary experiences for students in the curriculum. The educational scenario had a strong impact on students, teachers, and the local community. For students, the outcome was surprisingly positive, and the physical participation of the students increased from lesson to lesson. Inspired by the project, the students collaborated synchronously and asynchronously, combined conventional and innovative tools, used various research methods, and created their own original material. The students also changed their attitude towards physical education as predicted in a positive way. After the specific project, they were more open-minded and more eager to try sport activities. The impact on the teachers. The teachers recognized the benefits of interdisciplinary lessons and the interaction between the various cognitive fields, as the children asked for, after every law of physics or a mathematical problem, to perform an experiment or to associate it with an everyday human activity. The impact on local community was also great. They urged the school, when they learned about the innovative scenarios, to continue to perform similar projects and to assist in this direction when possible. This innovative practice, despite the fact that it was implemented in a small scale in school, it can also, with the use of ICT, be implemented in a larger scale to implement to participate foreign schools and universities from all over the world. So, in conclusion, the results from the implementation of this innovative educational project were a clear change of attitude towards physical education, both in school and in life. Furthermore, through the use of interdisciplinary material, the students were able to understand the relationship between these cognitive fields, and they realized in practice the meaning of a healthy mind in a healthy body. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It was very interesting to have an activity that was associated with physical education. It's the first time, really, since we've been involved in ODS that we see physical education teachers so motivated and active. And now we'll go back to science. I would like to invite Mrs. Maria Eleftheriou to approach. And Mrs. Eleftheriou is the national winner of the educational scenario that ODS organized, first of all, at national level here in Greece, and also at international level. She is one of the two international winners. And one of the prizes she got was a scholarship for the Open Discovery Space Summer School last July. So Maria will be presenting us today her winning educational scenario, which is entitled Landing on a Comet, the Rosetta Project.
Okay. Thank you very much for the invitation. I am a physicist and science teacher in the Lyceum of Tzermiadon in Crete. The title is Landing on a Comet, the Rosetta Project. This scenario and another one from a colleague from Portugal received the first prize in the Pan-European contest. And so, first of all, I want to show you my school. It's located at the mountains of Crete at 850 meters, so it is isolated from the big cities of the island. So we want to make good things in this school because we have less students. So we make some innovative projects, like we have a seismograph of the QCN project of the Stanford University. Pupils construct hydrobot last year. We have school programs with Arduino platforms. We had also a program with science and art. Last year we had Erasmus Plus. We participated in digital festival and much more. So before some time, I discovered the Open Discovery Space Portal and Inspiring Science. So we create the community of our school. And then we are working with this platform, the authoring tool. I think it's a very interesting tool, very powerful. We can put the scenario, as you know, to make information, description, the phases and activities, and all of this. So for us, the goal of this scenario has many aspects. The first aspect is that we want to implement it in the Greek curriculum, because the Greek curriculum is very dense, so we want to have it inside the real curriculum. So also we want two things. We want to stimulate the learning process through innovative techniques such as simulations and ICT tools. And also we want pupils, they will learn the physical and very important physical laws, but also we want to learn the latest scientific achievements, for example, in space science like this one. So our learning objectives are inquiring-based learning, working into teams, we want to learn to cooperate, search on the web, learn to find the necessary info. They will play and learn through ICT tools. We have interactive physics software, Scratch applications, Creator Simulator, all are freeware. As you see, we will approach the problem from different methods, and we want to work as a researcher and to test parameters. And I will show you that pupils find the specific value for the acceleration of gravity that is also very near to the real value according to references. Now, the first phase, introduction to the problem. Teacher has to organize the class into teams, presents teacher's latest achievement through videos and pictures, and then teacher makes a discussion and will give the guidelines and what we want to explore in this project. For this reason, I have here two pictures to show you. At the left, you see Rosetta. Rosetta has been launched for 11 years, at 2004, and after 10 years, found a comet. And last November, a small robot, like a laundry machine that weighs 100 kilos, makes two jumps. It was a failure in the laundry system of Philae's, so makes two big. The first was a big jump. It was the duration approximately at 2 hours at 1 kilometer high. And then Philae makes the second bounce. It was a duration about 7 minutes. So this failure for us is the crucial and the important element that here pupils will implement Newton's laws and will see if they can find the acceleration of gravity of this comet. The phase B is different things. To play at first, play with a Scratch application, for example. They can change the parameter of the acceleration and they can observe the different track of the object. And then they have to collect data. They can find it on the web. I have some numerical values like velocities or the duration and the heights of those two jumps. Then we can make a rough sketch to show to pupils what we want to make. So I divide the motion of Ile into five different parts. For example, 1, 3, and 5 are free falls, or the 2 and 4 is with the deceleration. And then pupils can assume that they have constant G, constant acceleration of gravity, and they can put the forms that are already know, as you see the first and the second, and they can find G that is equal to 10 minus 4 and also to another equation of motion of the height is again equal to 10 minus 4. So we find the same order of magnitude from analytical equations. Then we make something else. We have another method. We have the interactive physics. So we, the pupils have to make some tests. They will try to simulate the landing of Ile. So they put the two masses, for example, the mass to be the Earth and the other to be Ile or to be another planet and so on. So they put at first G equal to 9.81, it's like on Earth, and then we make G less and less. Here I will show you, sorry. I will show you one, this is a simulation, it's like on Earth. And if you put G equal to 1, you will see that the motion is slower. The three boxes that you see, it's the velocity versus time, for example, and the force versus time. And if we go to the smallest value that we can put in the interactive physics, is equal to 10 minus 3, you see that the motion is very, very slow. It's like the simulation on Ile's. So after that, pupils, they know that they know that the comet is not a rectangular or not a spherical, but now we will assume that this is spherical. We will put the radius of 1 kilometer, the real dimensions it's the same order of magnitude, and we deactivate the homogeneous gravity field and activate the planetary interaction between Ile and the comet. So the total force can be computed from the simulation, and I show you only this picture. You can see that the force is equal to 0.066 from the right box, and when we are at the surface of the comet, and then we can find that G equal to 0.00066. I have a small error, I missed a zero. So we have a comparison between two different methods. We have the analytical forms and we have the software for the interactive physics. So we found a very good agreement. Pupils are very happy because they found a similar result, and also are very happy because they searched on the web and they found that actually the gravity on the comet is equal to 10 minus 4 at the same order of magnitude. Now, I will finish the scenario with some other activities. I will show you only one. This activity is very, very nice. We can find it in the GoLab repository. It's the impact calculator on down to Earth. You can you can see what will happen if this comet fall on Earth. So, for example, if 67P comet fall on Earth in Paris. So you can choose projectile diameter, the projectile angle, the velocity, the different materials for the comet or for the planet. And we can have some numerical results, for example, kinetic energy or the impact energy, how frequent, so teacher can make a very nice discussion and with the pupils. And I finished, I have conclusions. I think that space science is very, very attractive. Pupils are always curious about space. Non-conventional way of teaching cultivate creativity. Interdisciplinary of the scenario increase pupils' motivation of learning. Also, I noticed that pupils of low grades are proved to be very skillful to ICT tools, ICT activities. And always a challenging problem gives inspiration to our pupils. And also for us, the teachers, I think the Open Discovery Space platform is a very powerful tool and gives many options. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. This was extremely interesting. Now, I would like to ask all the presenters to come and here with us and to take some questions for 3 minutes. We have to do it very quickly, though. Όλοι οι ομιλητές να έρθουν εδώ λίγο δίπλα μας για μερικές ερωτήσεις. Θα το κάνουμε όσο πιο γρήγορα γίνεται. Any questions, anybody?
I would like to raise the same question for everybody to give a short answer. What do you think is the main benefit for the learners from all the projects you have conducted in the school? If you just want to say a couple of words from the eyes of the learners.
We say it's our students. That's all. One word.
The other side. Eins in learning.
I'll answer in Greek. Το ότι δώσαμε την ευκαιρία, τουλάχιστον όσον αφορά.
The learners, two students in my case, who before that were completely marginalized, so they were given the chance to come into contact with students from other schools and to reach a level that would inspire them to go even further.
Let me to set goals, everybody can learn. And learning is fun.
I think that we have to give to our students the most great things that we already know, because we are scientists. So we have to, I think, to make a bridge between the universities and the schools. The school is like a small university, I think, and we have to inspire those students.
Anybody else?
Can I ask? Sorry. Okay. I usually close my presentations with a slide, with a photo of my 5-year-old son. Usually telling that I'm doing what I'm doing because I wish my son to gain a better education than that I got. This is what we got from this, we win from this situation.
Okay. In physical education, the latter years, child obesity is increasing. So what I gained and my students gained is they participated more actively in physical education. We try to motivate them to engage in sport activities for life. Thank you.
Do you think that the curriculum that comes from the Ministry of Education is very restrictive, so that there's no time left for other types of activities such those that you presented here? So what could you do about that?
If I may continue to answer. Okay. Yes, this is true. The curriculum is very strict. We have to exceed the expectations and to try more with personal cost for us as teachers and for students. For sometimes they have to stay and spend more time with us after school or at home to prepare a presentation, to understand something that we gave them. We spend a lot of time through Web2 tools to communicate in other hours that are more easy for our students. So we are on a 24/7 basis online and try to meet their expectations. Thank you.
Anybody else on that? Panagiota?
In this answer, I also agree. That's why through innovative teaching practices, we could transfer the knowledge from science classroom to real world and combine the fields of science, maths and physics, maths and chemistry in innovative project.
First, I would like to congratulate all the colleagues for your excellent work you're doing in your schools, and I would like to ask if you have you identified any practical difficulties about implementing the projects or your ideas in the school.
Only the beginning, perhaps in the first year or the second year, then it's going by itself. Only the beginning, in the first 1 or 2 years. After that, the students can work like this, the colleagues can support, it's easy.
Anybody else on that? On challenges and difficulties? Yanis?
Okay, you know, we have some problems in the Greek educational system. While the Greek government is trying to implement evaluation, so some activities are taken are will be evaluated in this procedure. So there is a great competition, sometimes or fight between teachers in order not to do some activities because they charge that you are doing what are you doing in order to get a better grade and the evaluation. I think this must be taken under consideration, under strong consideration, and also about the question asked before referred to how strict the Greek curriculum is. Yes, of course, it is very strict, and furthermore, we have some problems to implementing some innovative activities caused sometimes by conflicts between teachers and between the administration.
Okay, and so one more question, final question from Rosa.
Thank you, Stefanos. Actually, it's not a question, it's a wish, a suggestion for all of you. You excel in what you're doing, for sure. I mean, I know most of you, I've seen you in other places, you are one of those teachers that, in spite of everything, you move forward and you make your dreams come true. So I think you achieved a lot, and you can go higher in the ladder. But my wish for you, or my suggestion for you, is that you now try to reach out for others, for all the other teachers that are not in that table, for all the other teachers who are willing to do what you're doing, but somehow feel incapable of. Be ambassadors, be the ones, the actual leaders of change that will bring maybe colleagues in your schools, or if they are not willing to support your colleagues in other schools, in other countries, in other cities, there's so much need out there. So make the difference now by sharing what you have learned and inspiring others to follow your steps. Congratulations to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.